Hey guys, it's Julia and welcome back to my channel, and for today's video I'm going to be discussing some books with you guys that have to deal with grief. So grief is something everybody will go through at some point in their life, and it's important to have for obviously us readers to have literature to rely on a bit. And it just, even if you're not dealing with it right now, it just gives you insights to people who are. And like, you don't really know what's happening with anybody if they've dealt, like if they're dealing with any, like you don't, when you meet someone you don't know, like people in your classes or like people at your work, like you don't really know what they're dealing with. So it's just like, I don't know, I think it's important to talk about grief and to just read more about it. So I have a pile of books here, some young adults, some adults, that have to deal with the topic of grief. So let's jump right into it. First book I have here to talk about is Vengeance Road by Erin Bowman, a young adult Western novel that has to deal with a girl named Kate whose father was just murdered, and she is dealing with that, and she is out for revenge, and she disguises herself as a boy to like blend in and stuff. And it's about her basically in the desert and all the stuff that goes on down there. But the reason why I wanted to talk about this was it deals with a really interesting part of grief, and that is revenge, or vengeance, especially in this case. I've read a lot, like there's a ton of books out there where the protagonist wants revenge because someone was killed, especially, or usually that's the reason why. But that's just something that I wanted to mention, that this book does deal with, like, a girl who's looking for justice, and who's, and it's, like, this girl who's, like, bearing her grief to, like, and then filling herself up with, like, hatred towards someone. And so I want to talk about this book because I think it is important to mention the aspect of, like, someone's vendetta, because, you know, it's a thing that some people go, like, it's the path that some people go down if someone they love is killed, is revenge. It's very common for someone to want that if someone got killed, you know? But, not saying that I agree with that, but I just want to talk about this book. The second book actually comes out later this year, so I'm actually looking forward to that. This was my first Western, and I absolutely loved reading it. I love the setting of Westerns and, like, the vibe to them, so I definitely suggest picking this up. An adult one in there, and we'll mention The Virgin Suicides by Jeffrey Genetes, which this book is my favorite book ever, if you do not know, if you've never been here. But I love this book with all my heart. This is my third copy that I never usually hold up in videos, but I thought since I never hold it up, I'll hold up this copy instead of my other two. Basically, this book is about the five lesbian daughters who all commit suicide, and it's about these boys who live like across the street and who are just remembering these girls like years and years in the future and just trying to understand why they did it. And they're just reflecting back on how these girls impacted their lives and how like obsessive they were over them. And yeah, the thing I love about this book, well, I love so many things about this book, but it really just shows what one suicide can do to a family, because one daughter dies first, and it just shows what suicide can do to a family and how that, you know, how that is, it just so shows how suicide really affects a family. And I think that's super important to realize, and it gives us like a different point of view that we never usually get. And it shows how even people that they didn't even really acknowledge them, they weren't a part of their lives in a way, but the thing is it's just like I don't think they ever would have thought that these boys would care so much about them when they were gone. So it's just really, that's something I won't ever know. Like, that's something, like, the story never told us. Like, I won't ever know if the girls would have even thought the boys would, like, remember them. But I think that's just really interesting how suicide impacts so many lives and how devastating it is and how tragic everything is about it. So that's why I wanted to mention this book. But yes, Virgin Suicides, one of my favorite books ever. I'd highly recommend it. Obviously, if you are triggered by suicide or depression, I would not suggest picking this up. But I love this book with all my heart, so yeah. Next up here, we have The Last Time We Say Goodbye by Cynthia Hand. This is another young adult contemporary, and it deals with suicide again. So trigger warnings for suicide if that's something that you're uncomfortable reading about. See, basically this book deals with a girl whose brother just killed himself. So she had everything going for her, you know, the typical plot, you know, she had everything going for her. She had a boyfriend, she had friends, like she was happy. and then her brother killed himself and her world just spiraled around her. She started hallucinating, seeing him, and was like wondering if he actually died, like seeing his ghost. And it just shows a really, just another really interesting point of view, and another really devastating point of view about suicide. And to have like a sibling that does that is really just so tragic. And it was about them and what she's dealing with now and how her family is now and just all the effects like that. So I would just highly recommend this book. I barely ever I don't even remember the last time I talked about this book, but I loved it when I read it, so highly recommend it. In my last adult book, I have A Bird in the House by Margaret Lawrence. And I read this book for school recently, and we studied it in class. Follow a girl named Vanessa who's growing up and who's experiencing a lot of things, dealing with family issues, dealing with prejudices, and it's about her, like, maturing, and it's about her, like, maturing and growing up. And so it's a really, I really enjoyed this book. I really loved studying it. But I wanted to mention this because I can't mention who dies, obviously, but there is a death in this book that greatly impacts a lot of people, and it just, it just shows how much of an impact death can make on a family's life and like a life, anyone's life in general. So I just wanted to mention it for that reason. But yes, this is a great classic if you're looking to pick one up. The book I have here to talk about is The Inexplicable Logic of My Life by Benjamin O'Leary Sions. Brand new release, but I wanted to talk about it because it's about this boy named Sal who is living with his gay adoptive father and his Mexican-American family, and it's about him and his best friend, and he's dealing with something throughout this book. He's dealing with the fact that his grandmother is going to pass away soon. They are well aware of that fact, and it's about, throughout the book, we see how he's trying to accept that she's not going to be there anymore, but she's still alive. But like, it's about, it's different from the others because they haven't passed away yet. Just that it just really shows like a slower paced kind of death, and how a character knows that it's going to happen, and he's just kind of like waiting for it in a way. Yeah, it's super sad. It was an aspect of this book that was really interesting. It was one of those aspects of this book that I think was done very well. So I would just suggest picking this book up for that reason. I do have a review on this if you're interested in checking that out. I did have some other issues with it, but it was overall like an okay read. So yeah, there you guys have it. Those are the books that I wanted to mention today. I know this was like a more serious video. I'm trying not to make it as sad as it is, but I think it's still super important to talk about and discuss. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you're interested in checking out any of these books, let me know down below, or if you've read any, or if you have any recommendations for books that deal with grief and death and all that stuff, let me know down below, and I'll see you all very soon with a new video. Bye. He knows that he's killing me from my sleep, and here I go.